Yeah, we're really excited about our team coming into this year. In the last couple of years, we have always felt like we're a year away, 2 years away. I think we have a nice blend and balance of senior leadership and a good group of young rising stars. And I think it needs to start with the top. It needs to start with your leadership. I think if you look across the board from, our attack, midfield, defense, and goalie, and we have seniors in every position that have played for us for the last 4 years, since the day we walked on campus in State College. So having guys understand from start to finish what it's supposed to look like from their leaders that have come before them, that's been paramount through our development this fall. So I think expectations are high. I would say that these guys are starting to think a little bit more, about May, and more so than we have ever done before since we've been here on campus. The scope is much wider. We know the importance of every game this year, knowing that the CAA is not going to be an option for us in terms of just getting in through the AQ, but the discussion of the importance of each game as it leads to the opportunity to compete and play in the NCAA playoffs and win a game in the playoffs is much more relevant now than it's ever been. And I'm not here to say that those guys didn't think that it was possible beforehand, but I think having the opportunity to have played in the NCAA playoffs last year gives these guys an idea and a roadmap as to what it takes, how much effort they put in to get there. But I also think we have the experience and leadership now at the top to provide maybe a little bit more of a run if we're fortunate enough to get through the schedule that we have and get to that point in May. I think, part of it is just the excitement of having some veterans back like Shane Sturgis and TJ Sanders, but you also have some guys that maybe stand a little bit further back behind the front line, probably don't get as much attention as those guys do. I would say when you look at our offense, you look at Tommy LaCrosse, Shane Sturgis, and TJ Sanders, guys that have been there for us since the day they walked on campus. Guys like Gavin Ahern coming back has provided a tremendous amount of leadership behind the scenes. He's a guy that we're going to really rely on. And then we've got a lot of new guys that we're going to try to, find a role for this year. Kyle Vanthoff, I should say, he's a fifth-year senior. He's coming back, so we're going to rely on him a little bit. But then got some freshmen like Nick Aponte and Danny Craig at the midfield and attack, respectively, that we think are going to give us a nice boost offensively. We've got to find a way to be a little bit more productive at the midfield. So guys like Kyle Beyer, Matt Sexton, Eric Myers, Pat Manley, that crew right there that I think if you look is just maybe a notch below some of the guys like Shane Sturgis, Tommy, that have had the experience in production, productivity over the last 3 or 4 years, the guys that we're really going to rely on to step up and give us that production that we were drastically missing last year. So I think if we can get that group to step up and compete and play the way they're capable of, it's going to make Tommy's job, Shane's job, TJ's job a lot easier and give us a chance to be much more successful in the offensive end. Defensively, we have everybody back. That's the exciting part about having, you have a first-team All-American goalie in Austin Cowan, and then you have all three starters back defensively. Tyler Travis is a captain for us now. He'll be back for his fifth year alongside two juniors that have started since the day they walked on campus. And then I would say probably our most experienced and most talented position, if you combine the two, is our defensive midfield. We have three long stick middies in Stephen Bogert, Kessler Brown, James Burke. Kessler and Stephen have split time in their 3.5 years there. James Burke came out and played quite a bit of time for us last year as a freshman. He's wonderful off the wings of faceoffs, tremendously competitive and talented young man. To go along with the two short sticks, Michael Richards and Tommy O'Neill, with a young man named Taylor Stodhoff, coming in as the third guy. So we feel very good about the athleticism there and the talent there, and that could be our most talented position that we're able to put on the field on day one.